Howdy, y'all, and that is correct. We have the awesome, the amazing Massey Ferguson 27. I'm just checking my mic. I thought it was messed up. Okay, it's not messed up. But yeah, we'll get in here. Wait, I gotta start it. Just pushing the H button. Not even starting the machine. Yeah, we'll just start this. We'll let him run. See where he goes. See how he does. You go, man. And then, of course, I think you guys seen this already. I got this little guy. We're gonna take the cover off that just because. And then, what was my other plan? I can't even remember now. I think it was probably nothing, because I don't think I even have another tractor. I was gonna say we could like mow grass, but we don't actually have another tractor, so we can't do that. Okay. Anyway, that was totally my plan. I was gonna go mow grass, I thought. Alright, let's see what we have as far as what's going on here. 16. I can't do a mission there. Well, that's a bummer. 28. I can, but I'm pretty sure. Yeah, it's going to take a really long time. Okay, we don't want to do that. I guess it's just harvesting. I mean, I don't have another tractor. You know? I mean, that's a bummer. Alright, so what we can do is we can check prices. I'm kind of wondering. I think prices reset themselves after, like, if you exit and then come back in. At least it seems that way. Alright, let's take a load of corn to Blackerhall again. Is that a thing? Can you guys tell me if that's a thing? Because it seems like that's a thing. Like, that the, that the prices actually reset themselves if you exit the game and come back in. I wasn't even aware of that. I didn't even know that. I mean, there's nothing I can really do about it. I mean, I can't just leave the game running for, like, 24 hours, obviously. But, yeah. I can't remember, what was I doing yesterday? Oh, yeah, I harvested a field so we can buy, that combine. Amazing. I think we should get more tractors like this, like super old tractors. Really wish we could find some like old ones that were like, you know, super high horsepower and stuff. Which we've got those really big ones, so I guess I could probably use those. They're kind of neat looking once I get that far along. Alright, we need corn. Go and get us a bit of corn. And then Blackerhall's the one up north. No. Is that right? Blackerhall is just, yeah, okay. Go ahead and cover it over. Yep, there we go. Oh, now we don't have to swing all the way around there. We can just go like that. Where are those tracks from? That's weird. Alright. And since we have glance, we can watch our combine. Make sure it's not gonna like fill up. I'm actually gonna like really enjoy this tractor, I think. Super awesome. Some people may not like it very much just because it's tracks, you know, but you know what? You just, you know, whatever, deal with it. Hashtag, you know, track tractor. Thumbs up for the track tractor, I guess. See, this field isn't completely grown, but hopefully by the time that tiny combine makes it all the way over there, it'll be grown. And I need to get a plow, even a small one, for that matter, to plow that up. Actually plow it, instead of just change the texture. I wasn't, you know, aware of the fact that that was a thing, I guess. I kind of wonder, though, like, if I'll have to actually do, like, allow create field? You know what I'm saying? Like, I may not have to actually do, like, the allow create field. I might be able to just, like, do a plow. I'm not even sure. Really not going to be any way to test it. Like, you'd have to have, I'd have to bring the planter over to test it, I think. Oop, that's not the right way. Oh, money. Money, 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 money. How much would a plow be? How much horsepower do I have on this beast? 88. Mm-hmm. Yep. What's the smallest plow take? 85. We're in business. We're totally in business. 13,000. Yes, please. Plow. Alright, what's the price? Oh, it's went down some. Okay. So much for that idea. Alright, so what we'll do is we will probably go just empty the combine real quick. It's not really full, but we'll empty the combine and then we'll take this thing over and get us a plow. Unless. Hold on. How much did I pay for this tractor? Are these things super cheap? If they're super cheap, we'll just get another one. I mean, why not? 18,000. I can actually afford one. Ooh. 88. These are all 88. Okay. Series 672 without a cab. 2 something. What was up with that? Series 600. Ooh, this has got four-wheel drive, I think. Front loader attachment, engine setup. Ooh, yeah, I can't afford that. We're gonna get that. Let's. What does soybean sell for? 10,000 liters. Oh, we can take it to the balloon tree. Alright, yeah, that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna empty the combine, which did not actually go all the way down to the end, because he's a terrible combine driver. I hate that. That's so terrible. I wonder why it's like that. I don't even know. You guys know? If you can't tell, I am feeling better. My cold hasn't really officially subsided, but it is like tons better. But what we're going to do is we're going to collect this soybeans. Then we're going to go collect... Whoop, sorry. We're going to get the soybeans... I guess I can drive farther away, can I? We're going to get the soybeans out of the bin, and then we're going to go sell them and buy another small tractor. Put a plow on the back of it, and that will be our plowing tractor. This may actually end up being a farm with just really small machinery, just because it's so awesome. Except for like the planter. Like the planter tractor probably needs to be a little bigger than these other ones. And then since it's on tracks, I can just go boom. This isn't a very good view. Let's do that. And then let's do this. Boom. Alright, where's the balloon tree? It is all the way in the bottom. That's a bummer. He didn't go out of this side either. That's alright. We'll get all this when we're done. When we're like, you know, pretty close to the end. This is only 48. Yeah, we'll go get the stuff out of the bin. We've got plenty of time. I mean, that combine's not filling up very fast at all. Just means it's going to take him like a year to do the field. So he'll probably be doing that field for the next like 3 or 4 episodes. Crazy. Actually, we might have to get several of those combines. Maybe we'll just have like, we'll get like, one combine per field or something. Wouldn't that be crazy? If we just had like one combine for every field, we just like put like a little shed in the corner of the field, and then that'll be where the combine stays. Have a setup like that. That'd be so cool, right? And then eventually we can upgrade the tractor that's on this trailer and then put a second trailer and a third trailer and, you know, we'll have like 4 or 5 trailers on the same tractor. We'll go ahead and cover this over. We don't want it, you know, all over the place. Alright, let me look and see what the plat is to the thing. All the way down past the farm, go to the curve, blah blah blah. We'll look when we get down there. It'll be all good. Alright, that way. Isn't just way more fun? You know, first person driving, tractor, beacons going. Get out of the way, buddy. Alright. There's no mirrors on this thing, though. I guess it might be super dangerous to have mirrors on it. Like chugging along at 26 miles an hour. I could do with a whole lot of these tractors. Alright, so if you're watching this and you know an awesome like mod that you have noticed that I don't have, then maybe we'll just get like, you know, hit me up, you know, let me know. Maybe we'll get like a bunch of these little tractors. Alright, so what I need to do, I'm just probably gonna have to leave that up. I have no idea how to get there. I don't think I've ever been there. The Balloon Tree Farm Shop. What would be there? Might have to check here in a minute, see what it is exactly that they buy. I'm assuming they buy something. With the sell icon point thingy. Oh. Maybe I have been there? What did I... Whoa. Oh, I have been here, haven't I? Because I put that thing down. I must have come down here and sold something to this. Maybe wheat? Something? I don't remember. Looks like our sheep are starting to produce wool. You notice that when I was flipping through the thing earlier? You guys probably didn't notice. On the animal page. There were like, you know, numbers in red or something. Showing that the sheep were actually producing a little bit of wool. Some wool. I don't know what we're gonna do with that. I'm kind of debating on that. As to whether, like, you know, get a couple pallets, go sell it, or just, like, start stockpiling it. You know, if there's ever a great demand of wool, we'll have, like, 500 pallets of wool or something. And then just mass sell it. At some point, we're gonna have a semi-trailer that will automatically load pallets because it's awesome and we've got to. Just trying to figure out. Oh, this is where they sell the wool. Okay. Yeah, we've been here. I don't remember what we sold here, but we've been here. Booyah. Here we go. Monies. I did already buy a plow, didn't I? I think? Yes. Okay. Tractor. Ooh. 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 What's the biggest one? 20. They're all 88 horsepower. Well, maybe we'll just have one of each, you know? Alright, we'll start with this one then. I guess. Why is this one 45,000? Can you upgrade it? What's it up to? 115 horsepower. Isn't that just special? Alright, so we want a plowing tractor. We're looking for a plowing tractor. It needs to have four-wheel drive. This looks like a plowing tractor. That thing looks like it'd be mean. Yep, I like that one. Alright, we don't need a front loader because it's a plowing tractor. We do need as much horsepower as we can get out of it. Only 95 though. That's whatever. Wheel setup, rear twin wheels, narrow tires, wide tires, standard. Rear twin, yes sir. Design, forestry, standard. No, we don't want forestry. With warning triangles, absolutely. 28,000, sounds good. Wonder how the front weight thing works. Is there a front weight on this? Is there an option to put front weights on? Maybe. Is there a thing? Okay, yeah. I don't see any way to put, like, front weights on it, so I guess it'll just be that way. Alright, let's head out. Let's hit the road, Jack. So yeah, that'll be our little plowing Massey. And just so we know, don't mix them up and stuff, we'll just, you know, the plow will stay on that tractor, and then we'll get a different tractor for the other thing. Where did there I came from. Alright. We could probably actually, like, as long as we do hired workers, right, we could actually get, like, a small planter. Man, we might have just completely shifted the way this farm was going. You know, day one, rent out huge equipment, waste all of our money. Day two, buying really small stuff. 88 horsepower, 95 horsepower. I'll get there. But it means we can have, like, tons of tractors, though. I mean, all sorts of equipment and stuff. I need more mods, though. I'm gonna have to look at more tractor packs. More tractor packs, maybe, like, cultivators, seeders. Get some really cool stuff going. But what we'll probably maybe end up doing is, like, Just to make it easier, like eventually, probably not anytime soon, but eventually once we have like tons of fields going on, then we'll probably end up just like pretty much nixing out whatever part of the field the workers don't automatically do, you know? So like right now the combine's working, but it's missing that whole big bit at the end. So we'll probably just end up turning that into grass or something, whatever. It's not ideal, but it's also not ideal if you have like 10 fields going, if you're having to sit there and keep going and like covering where the combine's not covering, you know? If that makes any sense at all. Alright. Hitting it up, man, hitting it up. We just gotta... Why is he stopping way back there, man? This thing is terrible. Absolutely terrible. I have no idea what's wrong with this thing. Why do you choose this way? Why do you do this to me? Maybe it's because of the trees at the end? I'm not really sure. But see, like, it'd be easier right now. Like, if I just turn the end of the field here into grass. You know, then I don't ever have to worry about, like, going back and getting him and stuff. And since this is... We're going to take this down to the cruise control at 6 miles an hour. This will be our combine emptying tractor. Well, crap. If I can learn how to do it, that'd be great. Why are you not? This cruise control's messed up, I think. Okay, maybe this won't be the combine emptying tractor. Oh, nope, there it goes. It's pretty well fixed. Dun dun dun. Let's go ahead and stop you there. Turn off your beacon, turn off your engine. Switch over to looks like a mudding tractor, doesn't it? Alright, beacon. Big old beacon. Alright, do you have an option to do weights? What is this thing? Oh. No, you go away. Oh, okay, I get it now. Alright, we don't really mess with that. Is there anything if I do this? Or this? What's up with this? Why is there no... maybe it's a, maybe there's, is there a special weight for it? Let's see for, oh, there's this. Let's try that. Is that like the massy weight for it? I need a weight for it. I mean, you can't have a plowing tractor without weights on the front. That'd just be ridiculous. And then, yeah, there's no way to, like, alter the weights or anything like that, you know? Alright, here we go. Boom. It's not super big, but it is awesome. Is my beacon on? Yes, it is. Alright. We're set. Let's go, brother. Let's get on the road. Alright, I think there's a crossing before the field, right? I think there is. Yeah, there's one right there. Okay. Should be set. What's wrong with my mirror? Do you see my mirror just turn off right then for some reason? No reason? Stuff? Alright, here we go. Here we go. Thing like trail or how's it a little bit of oh game save probably. I'm trying to see if it trails at all. I think it does. This tractor is actually fairly wide for its size. Look out, car. There's a plow behind this tractor. Very careful. Plow. There's a plow. Plow behind this tractor. Don't hit the plow. I think I'm saying plow enough. I might be. not entirely certain. Alright, does this thing, like, unfold? To unfurl? Whoops. Messing with stuff to hit my microphone. Alright, here we go. It does kind of unfold, a little bit. Alright, let's turn this on. Let's see. That's obviously not the right way to do it. Maybe we'll just do like create field just because. Is that right? Yeah, limit to fields. Alright. Here we go. Not even 100% sure this is working. But it might be. Maybe I should move it over a bit. Definitely working. I can see it working right there. I guess when we go to planet, they will know if it's actually working, right? And if there's a little bit missed, then maybe we'll just come back and fix it sometime. It'll all be fine. And I'm not a professional plower, so nobody tell me that I suck at plowing. We're just doing it, getting it plowed up, getting it real good. I almost bet there's going to be like a little strip right there in there. It kind of looks like there's going to be like a little strip that doesn't actually get planted or whatever. Alright, here we go. Swing her around. Swing her around real good. Alright, and back in the furrow. There we go. Yeah. Maybe I should turn this back to grass first. That way I can actually see if it's doing anything. I'm assuming it's doing anything. It is on allow create fields or whatever. So, it better be doing something. We won't find out until it gets, you know, we harvest that and then plant and all that stuff. We won't even know. No telling, man. No telling. It's probably working, though. Alright, so our next task will be to we need a cedar for sure. So we need to look at cedars. We kinda need a cedar that has fertilizer already. But if we can't get one, then you know, it'll be fine. You know, it's not that big of a deal. If we can't get one, then we'll just get like a little fertilizer spreader. Is that annoying if I just keep saying spreader? It's making it slightly more, but it's fine. It'll all work out. Look at it pulling though. Pulls like a boss. What about him in here? Yeah. Yeah, I like it. Awesome. I'm not gonna hit that tree up there, am I? I would say, from my professional opinion, I have no idea. That would kind of stink if I did, but, you know. $200 wage payment? What? I paid that guy $200? That's terrible. $200 for an hour, though. I mean, that's... If I made $200 an hour, I probably wouldn't be doing YouTube. Actually, you never know. I might do YouTube. So I'm making $200 an hour. I mean, come on. I guess if you're making $200 an hour from YouTube, that would be even better. And I might have to actually, like, take that away from that tree a little bit. Or cut the tree out. You could always cut the tree out, I suppose. Right? This button. Press the X button. It doesn't really do much, the X button, but it does a little bit of something. Flip my tractor over. Alright, we'll go ahead and shut you off. Alright, so now our goal is we need, what did I say? A cedar. So we need a cedar, and we need a cedar tractor. Well, obviously. But we need to go park up our plow tractor. In our shed. In the shed. Shed. Over the farm. Dun-dun-dun-dun. I don't know why I keep doing that. It's like, you know, the shark. The shark thing. I haven't even been watching shark stuff, so I have no idea. I kind of feel like the reason they stopped so far from the edge of the field is something. It has something to do with, like, them being able to turn around. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, we'll probably just, like, try our best to kind of fix it, I suppose. We'll turn the edge of the field, like the end of the field, into grass. You know, it stinks, but I'd rather do it that way than to have him keep doing it like that, and then I have to go in and fix it every time. It'd just be better if, like, whenever he starts and then finishes, then he's actually done. That would be great. Alright, can I actually back this in? Apparently not. Will they work? It will work. Look at that. Like, professional backing maneuver. Alright. Beacon, engine, and store. Alright, so, sewing machines. Do I have any mods? I have this. But it doesn't actually have fertilizer. Okay, so see, that's the fertilizer symbol. But this is 4 meters? 4 meters isn't that good, though, is it? What is that? That's 3 meters. 4.5, 3. Alright, but this requires like 180 horses. What do we have? Fertilizer spreaders. We got this. It only holds 500 liters, though. But if it's a hired worker, then technically they're going to be, like, doing the fertilizer without me actually doing anything. So, what do you plant? The basics. See, if you get something like that, though, I mean, it's cheap, but the guy's going to take forever. And I think what we're going to have to do is probably just get this Rapid A600S eventually. Not at this second. Because it doesn't have fertilizer, though. What's the first one? That one has fertilizer. The Pronto. The Horse Pronto. Alright, so that one would probably be good. So $96,000. 270 horsepower, though. I don't know if we even have one that runs. 270, that's 145. 145. This is 210. Can I put a bigger engine in it? No. None of these. But will you take a bigger engine? Yes, but not big enough. What did I say? 270 horsepower? But I get one of these, maybe, but that's just too big. Yeah, what will you go up to? 250. 270? Why is it going to be so high? This is crazy. 203, 224. What will you go up to? Engine setup, 245. Was it 270? That's insane. 200. Why is it so big? Why is it going to be so much? 320. Yes, please. 410, but it's so expensive. I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do, guys. Should I just go with the Massey's? You know, just go with the Massey cedar. This little thing. Nothing. Should have kept the big one, I suppose. I don't know what to do. I've no idea. This is a tough decision. You gonna make it? You're not gonna make it. You won't make it at all. Why can't I do a straight line? Working out 27%, 21%. We're gonna finish out 11%, 6-0. Good deal. All right, buddy. What am I at? 70%. Yeah, it'll do another load. Oh wait, I just remembered. Okay, so all right, so another factor. If I got that sewing machine, the little Massey thing, then I've got to cultivate it, and I don't want to do that because that's just terrible. Then I'd have to have a cultivator tractor as well, and I just can't do it. That'd be way too much money. I might as well just buy, you know, a standard tractor, big cedar stuff. I just don't have the money for it. I just don't have the money right now. Why is this one not a fertilizer? That's just... ugh. This one does cultivate, right? Yes. So I need 96. And a lot of money. Alright, so 96,000 and... a whole lot of money. What do we say this thing does? So 267. So basically $365,000 or whatever. Way too much money. Alright, so that is 267 for one that will cover it. This is 225 and it'll cover it. Right? Yeah? What about you? That's exactly the right horsepower. And it's only 214. So not terrible, but not ideal, because we're still stuck. I suppose I could lease the cedar. It's not ideal. I guess I could just do some more missions off screen. We still owe a bunch of money to the bank, don't we? I didn't pay any of that back. No, I didn't. Okay. We're kind of stuck on that aspect. I don't really have a choice there. And you're still just chugging right along. Even though there's still a big old gap on this end of the field. Alright, What to do? I really want to try to, like, when I'm trying to do the missions, I'm always trying to, like, do them, like, close to the farm, like, fields that I'm going to buy. But it's super difficult, you know? Alright, this one shouldn't take very long. It'd take a lot less time if I actually started it, wouldn't it? That'd make total sense. Come on, tractor. Thank you. automatic, like this. Fertilize. Is fertilizing it? Yeah, okay. It was just hard to tell from back here. Couldn't really. I guess if you did this, that's, yeah, definitely fertilizing. Alright. Oh, yeah. See, and then if you sit here and do this, and then, you know, he's just going to fertilize the whole field without me even touching the keyboard again. But, I mean, what's the fun in that? This is why I do it off-screen, because it'd be super boring for you guys to watch, because I don't actually do much. I think for this one, though, we're going to turn that aspect off, and I'm actually going to, like, try to do a little bit of steering and, you know, make it look good. Turn that off. And this field's a little weird. Have you ever noticed that? Like, this field, this edge over here is not exactly straight. It's not on the straight and narrow. We'll turn the GPS off for now. So we're awesome at steering. Manual stuff. Kind of do like a headland sort of thing. Just because it's so crooked, can't really turn around very well with it, like this jagged edge on it. ...33% on the combine. See, that's what I'm concerned about, is just how long it takes to do this and the fact that the combine's running, but the fact that it's soybeans, the combine takes absolutely forever to actually, like, fill up. So it's really not too bad. We've got a long ways to go. Turn. Turn. Do the awesome turn. Alright, I'm kinda hoping we don't have to do that strip, but I'll bet we'll have to. I'll bet we will. That'll be like the last bit we do, though, honestly. 37 minutes already. Holy cow. 37 minutes. Man, the time goes so fast. So I'm having fun. I'm having fun with you guys. But that's going to be it for this episode. I'll immediately start the next episode so you can go ahead and just tune into that one. Thanks for joining me. Goodbye.